National Party have announced their intentions to establish an independent cancer agency and have pledged a $200 million fund towards cancer drugs should they be elected. Dr. Chris Jackson is the medical director for the Cancer Society and he joins us live from Dunedin. Good morning.
Kia ora, Hayley.
What do you think of this announcement from National?
Well, I think this is really good to see cross-party support now for strong central leadership on cancer, and it's a victory for people power. People have heard the call of the 142,000 people who signed Blair Vining's petition for better cancer care for all New Zealanders, and it's good to finally see some action. But that's not always been the case. I mean, National disestablished the Cancer Control Council, they abolished that, and they abolished the National Guidelines Group as well. So it's really good to see they've changed their mind on the need for central leadership.
Have they changed their mind in terms of giving cross-party support for central leadership, or are they saying, we'll do it, but only our way?
Yeah, well, I think the detail's still a bit sketchy, to be fair, and the policy announcement's quite light on the details as to exactly what it would look like. What is clear, though, is that we need cancer planning to be in the hands of experts, not in the hands of politicians. Otherwise, things move in these political cycles and you get these short-term announcements. One of the issues with the Cancer Drugs Fund, for example, is where did the number $50 million come from? Is that enough? We know that Herceptin costs around $20 to $25 million a year, pembrolizumab $20-odd million. So with a Cancer Drugs Fund of $50, you might only get one or two extra drugs, which isn't actually all that very much. And if you had an expert grouping looking at the structure of the fund, that might actually give us the best possible advice instead of cancer being a political football.
So $50 million per year is the fund that National did announce, so $200 million over 4 years. The Breast Cancer Foundation have come out and said that they would need $30 to $40 million per year alone, and that's just for breast cancer, and that PharmAc would need to double the current $220 million funding to spend on cancer drugs.
Yeah, well, that gives you a sense of how big the scale of the problem is and how far behind it is that we've got between New Zealand and Australia and the UK, for example. So we really are falling a long way behind. But it's important to remember that, you know, there's more to cancer control than just cancer drugs, and that investments in cancer control do have to be balanced. So, for example, for around $20 million, you could get rid of all of the waiting lists to see medical oncologists by doubling the number of specialists, and you could increase the reach of the bowel cancer screening program to include those age 50 as well. So you can't put all your eggs in one basket, and you do have to ensure that you've got a balanced investment program too, which is what a group led by experts would deliver, and that has to be outside the hands of the politicians. You don't just get the investments in the areas which are the issue of the day, and you get the investment in the areas which are really going to make the biggest long-term difference for Kiwis.
Are you expecting Labor to announce an independent organisation when they announce their cancer action plan?
Well, I'm not entirely sure what the final structure is going to be that Labor's going to announce, but there has been a signal that there is going to be a step change in terms of what we've been doing, and that's long overdue. We need strong sector leadership and we need experts in charge, not bureaucrats and not politicians, because the stuff that we need to do for cancer is becoming just critical. The numbers of people affected by cancer are going up, and if we don't do something soon, the entire health system's going to be crippled by the burden of cancer. And already people are missing out. We're hearing stories every day of people not being able to get their colonoscopies or their treatment, or are waiting too long to see a specialist. And unless we do something to turn this bus around, people are going to continue to suffer.
It's all going to cost a lot of money, though. And in New Zealand, we don't seem to have a lot of money. So how are we going to do this?
Yeah, well, some stuff does cost money, but there's other stuff you can do which doesn't cost a whole lot. I mean, there's clearly some hospitals that are doing very well at making sure that we pool our expertise and use the best expertise we've got and use what we've got to the most efficient extent is also what's important. But you've got to have that strong central leadership and that planning to achieve that. In Australia, where they've got a state-based cancer agency, the improvements in the standards they've had by centralising surgery have led to better outcomes from operations. And that's just doing better with what you've got. And that's the type of thing we need to look at in New Zealand as well. So, yep, we can do better with what we've got if we've got good planning and central leadership. And with a little bit more money, we could also help a whole lot more people.
Can you explain to us why we don't have central leadership here in New Zealand? Obviously, we've got DHBs who are making their decisions for their areas. How is that affecting us?
Yeah, well, I don't know if I can explain why we don't have national leadership, Hayley, because I think we should. And I think every other decent country does, and we did, but it got taken away. And that has led to 20 different DHBs, each doing their own thing. And we've seen that the standards are now varying wildly between the DHBs, and that's a real worry because they're just not being held to account. And when stuff goes wrong in a DHB, there's no mechanism for making that hospital lift their game and pull their socks up. It's what we need is an external agency or central leadership or strong central control to knock them back into line. And that may be revealing the extent of the problems that hospital needs extra coaching in that area, extra help in that area, or occasionally extra investment in that area. But something has to change, because what we've got right now is a bit of a mess.
Thank you so much. That's Dr. Chris Jackson from Dunedin. Thank you.